Hey, I'm Sonia. Welcome to CopyCat. This video is the first of the artist series, and I'm going to talk about John Baldessari, a conceptual artist from California. First, a note about conceptual art. It's abstract, but actually deceivingly simple. It focuses on the idea rather than the execution and on the dematerialization of art. An idea cannot be owned, only transmitted. Conceptual art points to something that is or used to be in the world. In conceptual art, the idea or concept is the most important aspect of the work. The idea becomes the machine that makes the art. Mr. John Baldessari literally dematerialized his art by cremating it. Pretty bold move. He is one of the most influential artists to emerge since the mid-1960s. His combinations of text and image paintings are the earliest examples of conceptual art. He explores language, written and visual, and questions the nature of communication by challenging the way we receive and interpret information. I am not too interested in this word or that word, but in what happens between those two words when they meet. Putting elements together creates something new. They do not make sense together, but now they do. The meeting of two media is a moment of revelation from which a new form is born. As soon as you put two things together, you get a story. The guy predicted meme culture. With photo collages, installations, paintings, photo compositions, videos, books, prints, photographs, texts, drawings, and sculptures, he subtly offers serious commentary by addressing the social impact of mass culture. So, why does this dude pull it off and anyone else can't? Well, he thought of it, which is the whole point of conceptual art, and he pushes the way we see words and interpret images by combining them and taking them apart. So no, your three-year-old has not been doing that in class lately. Or has she? Probably unconsciously. She is deconstructing language unconsciously. Baldessari invites new ways of looking at images with dots. He likes to cut out essential parts of an image to see what it becomes, because meaning, like language, can be constructed only from context. With a sense of humor, dots cancel out the powerful figure of the image and lets the eye explore the rest. What the dots conceal also becomes more visible. Our mind fills in the blank. Don't look at that. Makes you look at that. How do we read images, especially those pop culture artifacts that reinforce various gender, class, or racial stereotypes? Looking at this image, you wouldn't assume their faces look like this. Baldessari's work is a perfect example of lateral thinking. He was innovative in creating a new way of looking at images and words. His work is a great reference to visualize a subject that is not material. Experiences that exist, but you don't need to go any particular place to experience. Inspired by his work, you can play with your audience anticipation and assumptions of the world around them. Thanks, John, and thank you for watching.